it's what the Livestock Conservancy is doing is important to conserve unique, diverse animal genetics. That's really important. And encouraging people to raise them. You have a lot of people that are retiring now that want to raise a few animals. Well, instead of just raising regular animals, they might as well just raise some heritage animals. So at the same time, yep, they're having some specialty meat for a high-end restaurant, but they also are preserving that genetics, and we're going to have to eat some of them to preserve them because that farmer has to get paid to raise them. Well, the Livestock Conservancy has got some good materials on their website. I've been on that, and they have descriptions of different kinds of breeds. They also have a really nice thing on how difficult or easy a particular breed of cattle, pig, or horse would be to raise. You know, there might be some animals that are definitely not for beginners because their temperament might be different. It's super important to maintain diverse genetics. That is why there are seed banks. And the only way that we can do something similar in animals is you have to breed them and raise them. You can't put it in seed banks. Yes, there's some things you can do with preserving semen and ova, but that's very expensive. It's also very fragile. I mean, you're gonna better have a big generator to keep that going when there's a power failure. If you're raising a heritage breed, I think one of your reasons for raising it is to serve as a genetics bank. So don't go crazy trying to make your heritage breed be like a modern animal that gains really fast, because if you do that, you may lose some of the valuable disease resistance and hardiness traits. That's something you don't want to do. I think it's important, unique breeds of animals, all different kinds of animals, it's important to save them. Because if you lose that genetics, you have lost it. And the only way you can preserve unique genetics in animals is you have to raise them.